Dr. Bhatta, hello and welcome to So Janelle. Thank you for joining us.
Hello.
Doctor, I guess the first thing that I want to know is protocol. Like for people out there that are watching, when do they call 911? When do they go to the ER? When do they go to urgent care? What symptoms must they be feeling and should they be alarmed?
Absolutely. That's a very good question. We're getting this question all the time. Definitely the problem that we're having with this virus is that the symptoms could be no symptoms whatsoever to very, very severe symptoms. So what we are generally advising, and which is based off of the CDC as well, is that should you feel any symptoms right now of a sore throat, any fever, remember in this COVID-19 coronavirus that we are dealing with, it can be low-grade fevers. So 99, 99.2, up to 100, we're not always seeing the really high fevers like 105. Even if it's a temperature of 99, accompanied by a cough, scratchy throat, lack of smell, overall weakness, definitely not feeling like yourself, these are signs of possibly that you may have it. So at that point, what the protocol is that you want to quarantine yourself away from your family or whomever you are living with. Okay. This is not the easiest thing to do, but definitely at that point, you want to limit your interaction with anybody. Anything that you've touched or been in interaction with in the home setting should be cleaned off with any kind of Lysol or antiviral cleaning product. And then you should definitely give a call out to your primary care doctor or the nearest urgent care. In terms of what alarm symptoms you want to look out for in yourself or someone you're caring for or a family member that would warrant an ER visit or a 911 visit, these are symptoms of severe lack of oxygen. So, for example, if you cannot catch your breath, if the coughing doesn't stop, if your loved one or yourself starting to notice that your lips may be turning a little bit blue, if your loved one or the person you're caring for or yourself is starting to feel a bit more confused, if the chest pain feels different, if you literally feel like you cannot catch your breath at all, this is very alarming and you should definitely call 911.
Right. And while there are people that are testing positive, and obviously there's more now, and there is also concern. So say, for example, your office mate that you had interaction with tested positive. What do you then do?
So this is a very case-by-case situation. Unfortunately, there is no correct answer of what to do right now. The fact of the matter is that there are a lot of people who are positive that are not symptomatic. So chances are we have all been in closer than what we would want contact with somebody who is positive. However, with that being said, if you are in close interaction with somebody who is positive, you should probably also be self-quarantined. And again, speak to your primary care doctor or urgent care doctor, and they can help guide you on a case-by-case basis of whether or not you should go and get yourself tested. Because the only way that we can even control this is right now is getting anyone and everyone who may be positive isolated while they are still contagious. And that way, this spreads the virus from getting even more widespread.
In terms of the peak, do you believe that we have reached the peak or we're still on our way to peak, or can something be done so that we don't get to the peak?
What we are seeing in California especially and you know, widespread along the West Coast as of now is that we seem to be in a situation where things are a bit contained. Mm-hmm. So we're not seeing huge rises in number. That doesn't mean that we're seeing a decrease in number either. We're seeing sort of what we call a plateau. Mm-hmm. However, we are seeing certain areas that are becoming a bit concerning, and these are the nursing homes and the convalescent homes. We are seeing huge numbers of our elderly patients who are in the nursing facilities who are already sick or immunocompromised, that are slowly starting to show symptoms. We're getting increasing numbers from these nursing homes every day. And we're concerned that that may mean that we are not yet at our peak. These patients are coming in often sicker than the rest of the patients. These are usually patients that are going directly to the ICU. So while we have some promising information that we might be at a plateau here, we definitely don't know, and the worst could be yet to come as we see that there is still widespread disease out there.
Suffice to say, we still cannot rest on our laurels. We still have to follow strict social distancing measures.
Absolutely. And you know, for me personally, also, I have little kids at home and a family, and we're out and about all the time before this. And so, you know, if anything, we can tell everyone that we understand how hard it is. We understand that the huge amount of patience it takes right now, and that even, you know, there are no straight answers. There are no actual, you know, complete guidelines that we can follow. Everyone is figuring this out as we go. And so we thank everybody for being patient with us and trusting us. But for now, stay home, stay distant from one another, and stay positive too.
Perfect. Thank you so much for those parting words as well. You guys take care as well, and thank you for your sacrifice and your service.